Today, I'm going to be talking of one of the hottest topics in the packaging industry nowadays, sustainability. We are working with our partners and with our customers and being by their side with anything that they need related to this new challenge. We have five strategies. The first strategy, it's adopting, making the use of the materials and reduce it. It seems easy, it seems something trivial, but it's not. We are developing a set of technologies to try to help on that. So when we are doing the process of packaging, we are using less packaging. The second strategy, also really important, is the adoption of all the new material stream that is coming from the converters. Basically, it's polyolefin-based materials that are creating new structures that can be machined with other machines. There are two different materials that are used inside of this polyolefin big group, which are the polyethylene or polypropylene. Both materials, they can be used as a monolayer film, but it's complicated. Why? Because really the difference or the gap of temperature between the inner layer and the outer layer, it's zero because it's the same material. So you cannot seal it. It will melt from the outer layer before it melts from the inner layer. So the converters, what they are doing is creating a laminate that has different layers. Basically, it's to create this big difference in between the outer layer and the inner layer. So when we seal, it seals from the inside, but it does not melt from the outside. The third strategy, it's adopting recycled material. What does it mean? As I mentioned, the converters, they make structures with different layers. This means that on that layers, some of the materials, they are not virgin materials. They are what they call PCR materials, which are materials that come from the recyclable stream. So it's a material that has been used before. Doing so, we are putting effort to get into the circular economy. So the fourth technology is the use of materials which are either biodegradable or compostable. This means that the raw material for this, it's not polyolefin, so it's not petrol, is biological elements. Like it can be, I don't know, seagrass, or it can be food waste, all these type of materials that can be treated with a bacteria and that we can extract plastic from them. The fifth strategy, it's adopting paper. So changing completely from plastic into paper. This strategy is challenging as well because paper, as you for sure know, it's not thermosealable. So it means that inside the paper, we have to add a layer of some material that can be attached to the paper and can be thermosealed. All these projects, they have two outcomes that are really important. The first one is strictly related to the machines. So we are developing a set of technologies that can be incorporated to our machines, but not just on newer machines, also for our existing install base. We focused a lot on creating retrofit kits that can be added to that machines, so that machines will be able to work with the materials. The second outcome is we have created what we call the map of materials, that basically it's from all the tests that we have done on our machines. We record that tests and we know the structure used, we know the parameters used, so we can assess better our customers once they want to try a material that will have similar compositions. In here, in MESPAC, where am I right now, it's what we call the innovation center. In this innovation center, we have a machine that is fully dedicated for tests. So for any of you who would be interested in testing materials, we have open doors, you can book a day, you can come here, and we can try that material.